Let's take a look at how individual transactions are added to the blockchain. Bob wants to send a Bitcoin to Alice. Each user of the Bitcoin currency has their own Bitcoin address, similar to the account number of a bank account. These addresses are used to send or receive Bitcoin. The Bitcoin address is basically an easier to read version of something called a public key, which is a large group of numbers. Every public key corresponds to a private key. This use of pairs of keys, called public key cryptography, is a cryptographic system that provides authentication and encryption. If we compared the address or public key to a bank account number, then the private key is similar to the password of your bank account. You can show everybody your public key, but nobody should know your private key. In a similar way that you must sign a paper check with a physical signature to authorize its use, in order to authorize a transaction from your Bitcoin address, you have to sign it with a digital signature. The digital signature is a way of showing that you own a private key to the corresponding public key, without having to reveal it. The digital signature is unique for every transaction, so nobody can copy it and use it for another transaction. After you sign the transaction, it's authorized. Then the node that you are connected to announces this transaction to the Bitcoin network. Network participants called miners want to add new transactions to the Bitcoin blockchain, because they receive rewards for this action. That's why they listen for announcements of new transactions, then collect the announced transactions, check if they are legitimate, and bundle them into something called a block. A block contains, among other things, these new transactions, and an identifier of the previous block. Because every block contains an identifier of the previous block, the blocks are linked. And that's why it's called a blockchain, because the blocks are linked like a chain. In order to add this block to the blockchain, the miners also have to include something called a proof of work. The proof of work is a mathematical problem that the miners try to solve. You can imagine this as though you were trying to find the right combination to a combination lock. It is very hard to find the right combination if you don't already know it, but it's very easy to prove that you have the right combination. The miners basically try out different combinations to find the right one. This costs a lot of computing power and electricity. Hundred thousands of miners try to solve the same problem, but only one can get it right. On average, they are able to do this every 10 minutes. The more people who work at the same time to solve the problem, the more difficult it becomes to solve. Sticking with the combination lock example, adding more people would add more digits to the combination code. The difficulty of solving the problem increases because it is important that a new block of transactions is only added every 10 minutes. More on that in a moment. But why do we need a proof of work? In order to be decentralized, the Bitcoin protocol needs to make sure that no single entity can insert new transaction data into the blockchain repeatedly. If this were allowed, the network would have to trust that entity not to manipulate the blockchain in its favor. Through the proof of work system, the protocol makes sure that new transactions are added by one randomly chosen participant, the miner who gets lucky and finds the solution the fastest. Because finding the solution costs computing power, spamming the network with solutions is also prevented. The miner who gets a proof of work right is now able to add the block with the new transactions to the blockchain. For that, he receives a reward in Bitcoin. At the moment of this recording, the reward is 12.5 Bitcoins plus fees, which is around $100,000. Most miners don't mine on their own. They participate in large mining pools, which work like betting pools. The rewards are then distributed depending on how much computing power the miner contributes. The mining reward is the only way Bitcoins are created. Currently, 80% of all Bitcoins have already been mined. It is expected that by the year 2140, the maximum supply of 21 million Bitcoins will be reached. This is why it is important that new Bitcoins are only created every 10 minutes. No matter how many people participate. The Bitcoin protocol ensures that the supply is limited and Bitcoins are only minted as planned. Okay, now let's get back to our transaction. After the new block is added to the blockchain, the node announces a new block to the Bitcoin network. The other nodes in the network check if this is legitimate and then also add the new block to their copy of the blockchain. Now the transaction is complete. To be really sure that the transaction was included in the blockchain, you should wait until a couple more blocks with transactions have been added after the block containing your transaction. In the next video, you will see why this can be important.